Hello everyone, I am Saveri and I am here with a very interesting topic, that is, why do firms exist? This particular video is in continuation with our previous video of consumer surplus and producer surplus. So let's start with our concept that why do firms exist? And this question was answered by Robert Coates in the year 1991, where he asks you to imagine a world where there are no firms. So let's say you have to buy a car. So there is no Maruti Suzuki, there is no Ford. So what will happen to the manufacturing process? So one person would be making the body of the car, then the other person would be making the wheels. Then the person will buy the body, attach the wheels. Now the person who is making the engine will buy all these components. Then you will get a final car. So this process becomes the assembly line of one single firm. And this is a very tedious process. So course say, one, this process is tedious because there is transactional cost. Transactional cost means that every time you have to sell us something, you have to transport it to a different place. Also, you have to bargain every time. So this is a very tedious task and this adds up to your transactional cost. If you have a firm, then all these costs would be saved. Other thing is, specialization will only take place when you have a firm. Let's consider Maruti Suzuki. So Maruti Suzuki has specialized in manufacturing cars which are very economical and very sturdy. So this will happen only when you have a firm. So this explains your why do firms exist topic. So I hope this video will help you. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.